Hello friends, how are you? I hope you are in good health. Today we start with our new topic that is band theory of solids. Solids, we know we have three states of matter, liquid, gas and solid. And solids have very special characteristics and many applications in our day-to-day life. So what are the properties of solids, and that depend on band structure. So what is the band structure that we are going to study now? Before going to band structure, what is structure of the atom, or what is the accepted atom model? You think over it. We know different atom models. Sommerfeld's atom model, Rutherford's atom model. Then all of you have studied Bohr atom model, and we think that it is the well accepted model. But Bohr atom model is applicable only for the element like hydrogen, where we have only one electron. And we know hydrogen spectrum is a line spectrum. I hope you know the types of spectrum: line spectrum, band spectrum and continuous spectrum. So why do you get the band structure, or why do you get the continuous spectrum? We don't get that continuous or band spectrum in hydrogen because there is only one electron. But for higher elements, there are more number of electrons, and electron-electron interaction becomes dominant, that gives rise to multiplicity of energy levels. Means we don't have single energy level, but we have a number of energy levels. So we get a band, or we get a continuous spectrum. So it means we require the new atom model, and that new atom model is the vector atom model. You are well familiar with it. We'll just revise this point. So according to vector atom model, again the same thing, there is nucleus at the center and electrons are orbiting around the nucleus. Now these electrons, they are having four quantum numbers. The first is the principal quantum number, it is n. It can take the value 1, 2, 3, etc. Means the first orbit, second orbit, third orbit. The next quantum number is azimuthal or orbital quantum number. It is represented by letter L, and it can take the values from 0 to n minus 1. So for first orbit, n equal to 1, so L will be only 0. Now we know the first orbit has only a suborbital. N equal to 2, it is 0. 1. We know for second orbit, we have s orbital, p orbital. And when n equal to 3, it is 0, 1, 2. You know for third energy level, we have 3 suborbitals, s, p, d. I hope you know that, you have studied it in chemistry. The next quantum number is magnetic quantum number. It is m. It can take the values from minus L to plus L. Now s, we know it doesn't have any again suborbital. So here again we have 0, 1. So 0 means 2s and 1 means 2p. And we know p orbital has 3 suborbitals, px, py, pz. Similarly, d has 5 suborbitals, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. And then spin quantum number, it is s. It is plus minus half. Now we know every suborbital has capacity of 2, one for plus half and other for minus half, because we know electrons are revolving around the nucleus. At the same time, they have spin motion, plus half and minus half. So this is about the four quantum numbers. Now we can say that these four quantum numbers that give the address of the electron in the atom. Suppose you are given the four quantum numbers as 1, 0, 0, half. It means we are considering the electron in 1s orbital. If we say the four quantum numbers as 2, 1, minus 1, plus half, it means it is second orbit, it is p orbital, it is px suborbital, and spin is plus half. So we can imagine where is our electron in the atom. So we can say that it gives the address of the electron in the atom. Now, electrons obey Pauli's exclusion principle. Pauli is a scientist. He put forth his principle and we call it as a Pauli's exclusion principle. So, what is this principle? Now, we know electrons are having four quantum numbers. Now, according to this principle, no two electrons can have all the four quantum numbers same. See, for example, if we consider the two electrons in the 1s orbit, then it will have one orbital quantum number 0, magnetic quantum number 0. See, these three quantum numbers are same, but fourth is not same. One will be having plus half, other will be having minus half. So, all the four quantum numbers cannot be same. So, now I told you that four quantum numbers give the address of the electron. And no two electrons can have all the same quantum numbers. Does it mean no two electrons can accommodate the same energy level? If these four quantum numbers or the energy levels, if we say it is the room or cabin of the electron, can we say one cabin is shared by only one electron, or electron doesn't allow its friend to enter his cabin? That is the meaning of Pauli's exclusion principle. Now we study formation of energy bands in solid. For that I will show you one diagram. Consider one the simple case of two atoms, and very simple case we consider that there are only two electrons in the outermost orbit. Now see, these two electrons are far away from each other. If they are far away from each other, there is no any interaction between these two atoms. So, we call them as they are at infinite. Actually, in physics, there is no infinity. If there is no interaction, the distance is such that there is no interaction, we call it infinite distance. Now, these two atoms, they start moving towards each other. Got it? In the beginning, they are at infinite distance, no interaction. Now, they start moving towards each other. Now, as they come closer, the nucleus of one is attracted by electrons of other and vice versa. Okay. So, due to this attraction, they come closer and finally, we get this structure. Their outermost orbits, they overlap. You can see here, their outermost orbits overlap. So, these two atoms are identical, so outermost orbits overlap. So, do we get the situation, these two electrons have all the four quantum numbers same? Are you getting my point now? These outermost orbits overlap. So, quantum numbers of these electrons and quantum numbers of these electrons are same. And it is not allowed by Pauli's principle. So, Pauli's principle is applied to this system of two atoms as a whole. So, what happens now? See, this is the original energy level which has these four quantum numbers. So, this energy level is split into two energy levels. Is it clear? Because two electrons cannot live in the same energy level, cannot stay in the same energy level according to Pauli's principle. It is not allowed. So, what happens? This energy level is split into two energy levels, one at slightly higher energy and other has slightly lower energy. So, one electron will occupy this level and other electron will occupy this level. Is it clear? I will again repeat. Two atoms are at infinite distance, no interaction. They start approaching. As they come close, there is interaction between electrons and nuclei of the two atoms. So, outermost energy levels overlap as shown. So, all the four quantum numbers are same, which is not allowed. So, energy level is split into two energy levels. See here, two atoms. So, one energy level is split into two. Two atoms, two energy levels. My question to you, now we know in a solid, there are not only two atoms. Large number of atoms come together to form a solid. Now, suppose n number of atoms come together to form a solid. So, each energy level is split into how many levels? I hope you get my question. See, two atoms, energy level is split into two energy levels. Now n number of atoms, again the same thing will happen. N number of atoms come closer, their outermost energy levels overlap. So outermost electrons, they become common. Just here, these two atoms, they become common. Sorry, these two electrons, they become common to these two atoms. Similarly, when n number of atoms come close, there will be n electrons, and all these n electrons will become common to all the n atoms. Then this energy level will be split into how many energy levels? Just pause for a while and write your answer. I hope you have written your answer. Answer is simple. Now there are, when two atoms are there, then there is, each energy level is split into two. Now if n atoms are there, each energy level will be split into n number of levels. It is shown here. Consider it is innermost energy levels are unaffected. Only valence band, valence energy levels are interact. So as they come, this is at further distance, we have 2p energy level, 2s, no change. As they come close, in s orbital, we know capacity is 2. So we consider 2n electrons, it is split into 2n energy levels. And we know capacity of p is 6. So there are 6n electrons, so it is split into 6n states. So this is one band, 2p band, and this is 2s band. Why do we call it as a band? Because each level is split into n number of levels. Now these n number of levels are very very close that it forms a continuous band, and that is the formation of bands in solid. So this is the band 2s, this is the band 2p, and this is the gap between two energy bands, and that is called forbidden energy gap. Okay, so we will take one example. For example, lithium. We know atomic number of lithium is 3. So configuration 1s2, 2s1. So we get a band, like this is the atom, we have single energy level n equal to 1, 2, 3. But when metal we consider, this is the 1s band, it is completely filled. This is the 2s band, it is half filled. And this is the 2p band, it is totally empty. I hope you have understood the formation of bands. So there is valence band, conduction band, and forbidden gap. As we discussed now, the innermost energy levels are not affected. Only valence energy level is occupied, is affected. So the band which contains valence electron is called valence band. It is completely or half filled. The next higher permitted band means this band. This is next, this is valence band, this is next band. It is the conduction band. And this is the gap between valence band and conduction band. This is energy gap. Okay. This is valence band, this is conduction band, and this is energy gap. So can we say energy required to excite the electron from valence band to conduction band as forbidden energy gap. So this is about the formation of bands in solid. Okay. So today we stop here. In the next video, we'll discuss about the classification of solid.